video is sponsored by Skillshare, which is a place where you can learn basically any skill set for less than $10. More on that later in the video. When you look at this picture, there's probably a few star patterns that stand out to you. For me, my eye is instantly drawn to the Big Dipper pattern, and I also notice Cassiopeia on the right side. And after years of studying the sky, I know that Ursa Minor, or the Little Dipper, is in between these two star patterns. And one of the major questions I get as an astronomy teacher is, how do you tell the difference between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper, and how do you find the North Star? So in this video, we're going to review the similarities and differences between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper and how you can use them both to find Polaris, also called the North Star. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. Let's jump in with the major differences between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper. The Big Dipper, the handle curves differently than it does in the Little Dipper. In this picture, it appears to curve downwards, where here it appears to curve upwards. And I'm a little cautious using the word up and down because the orientation of this star pattern can change in the sky. So up and down are kind of a relative term here. The Big Dipper is also larger in size, and if you notice, its seven stars are of fairly equal magnitude, and that's not the same in terms of the Little Dipper. Here, the Little Dipper, only three of the stars appear to be brighter, where the other four are very difficult to see, and we'll get some practice later on in this video with the fact that you can really only see three of the stars in the seven star pattern of the Little Dipper. The handle also appears to kind of curve in a different direction when compared to the Big Dipper, and it's definitely smaller in size. So these are the three main differences. So now let's get some practice with identifying each type of constellation, or rather asterism, because the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper are not true constellations. They are names of asterisms. So here's that first picture I showed you, and are you able to find the Big Dipper towards the left side of the photograph? And then from there, if you can find the Big Dipper, you should use the pointer stars to aim you towards Polaris, which is the North Star. This star is pretty much in the center of this photograph. And then notice that the handle is curving differently than it does here. And in fact, they are similar curves, but it's just the orientation of the pots are slightly different as well. So here is where
the Little Dipper
is, and notice that only three of the stars are fairly bright, where the other four are more difficult to see. And this is a very good picture of the night sky. You typically don't see this many stars, but this is a long exposure photograph, so you can see those stars just shine a little bit brighter in this photograph. I will show you a little bit more realistic picture of what these star patterns look like. This is where the Big Dipper is. This is where the Little Dipper is. We have Cassiopeia over here. You can also use Cassiopeia to help orient you towards Polaris as well, as you can see in this picture. And there are a few other constellations here as well. We have Draco, or at least the tail of Draco, some of the body of Draco, and then Cepheus the King. All of these five star patterns are circumpolar, which means that they can be seen all year round. But our focus for this video is the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper. And these are actually asterisms. They're not true star patterns. And what that means is that an asterism is a simple star pattern that can be used as a guide to the night sky. So in the next portion of this video, we're going to look at the Big Dipper a little bit more closely, as well as the Little Dipper. And then we'll do some practice shots to help us get used to how to tell them apart in the sky and how to find them. Before we move on, I would like to tell you more about the sponsor for this video, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with a wide variety of tutorials. These are video-based quality lessons that can teach you anything from photography to business skills to cooking or even animation. And they're really good practical courses. And even though I'm a professional educator, I'm also a major believer that you can acquire any type of skill on your own outside of a formal environment. So there's a link in my description, and the first 1,000 people to use the link will get 1 month free trial of Skillshare, and it's a really great deal. So go click the link and take a course. For me, I've been using Skillshare to learn how to reach a greater audience through new platforms like TikTok. This has been a huge transition for me, and the course called Mastering TikTok by Taylor Lauren has really helped me to face my fears and just get my content posted. I've been making videos a particular way for many years, and this course was able to guide me through this new platform. So I highly encourage each of you to use my link and check it out. And remember, self-growth is achievable through Skillshare. Now we'll go over the specifics of the Big Dipper asterism. It is a collection of 7 stars in this very recognizable star pattern, and it has very many names depending on where you live and which point of history you are looking at. Some names include the plow, the wagon, the saucepan. The list is exhaustive, and I can't really truly know all the names of the Big Dipper. But in the United States, which is where I'm from, it's often known as the Big Dipper. And this is a circumpolar star pattern, which means that it can be seen all year round in the northern hemisphere. But the Big Dipper is really a part of a larger constellation called Ursa Major. And the way that I can tell the difference between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper are the stars. It's, if I reverse here, these 7 main stars are all of similar brightness, and that is not the same when we speak of the Little Dipper. And the Big Dipper is one of the first star patterns I teach to all of my students because it's such a helpful constellation. It can be used to find Polaris, the North Star, by using the pointer stars. If you use the pointer stars and move in this direction, it'll point you towards Leo. And you can use the handle of the Dipper to arc to Arcturus and speed to Spica. The list goes on and on and on here. So if there's one star pattern you need to know to help you find other star patterns, the Big Dipper is it. Here's another photograph I have. So are you starting to recognize that very easy star pattern to see? That's the Big Dipper. And remember, it's part of the constellation known as Ursa Major. And Ursa Major is a huge constellation. It's like the third largest in the sky, and it can be seen all year round in the northern hemisphere. And there again is where the Big Dipper is. And it is useful in finding the Little Dipper because you can use the pointer stars right here to aim you towards Polaris, which is the North Star. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in the next portion of this video. Now let's dive into the Little Dipper asterism. This is also a collection of 7 stars that are in a very recognizable star pattern. And how it's different from the Big Dipper is that the Little Dipper and the constellation pattern Ursa Minor are exactly the same star pattern. So you can't say that about the Big Dipper. And one thing I want you to notice is that the stars here are not of equal brightness, and this is what makes it really challenging to find the Little Dipper. And just like the Big Dipper, it is a circumpolar star pattern, which means that it can be seen all year round in the northern hemisphere. And this is such an important constellation to recognize, or rather asterism. I guess I can say both asterism and constellation because they are the same pattern, but it contains the star known as Polaris. And this is the star that is located at the tip of the handle in the Dipper shape of the Little Dipper. And this is such an important constellation, or star rather, because it points us in the direction of north. And it's the star that appears to not move in the sky. And this is very helpful when it comes to celestial navigation. So let's get some practice. Are you able to notice the Little Dipper pattern here? Notice the 3 bright stars right there. And hopefully you can find the handle of the Little Dipper. It does curve differently than the Big Dipper. If this were the Big Dipper, the handle would curve down this way. So let's get a little bit more practice with how to find the Little Dipper and Big Dipper in the sky. So this picture is a little bit more realistic version of what you would see if you were to go out in the night sky. It's different in the sense that this is a long exposure photograph. So, and it definitely has some filters on it. So it allows us to see more starlight, but this is more realistic of what you would see. And if you're wondering what this is the side of the house where this picture was taken. So first thing, I can kind of direct you towards where the Big Dipper is. It's in the center upper portion of this photograph, right here. And if you find the Big Dipper, you want to use the pointer stars to point you towards Polaris, which is right here. It's not a very bright star in the sky, and that's one of the misconceptions about the North Star, is that it's the brightest star in the night sky, but it definitely is not. It's like the 48th brightest star in the sky. It is a very difficult constellation to see in the night sky, and you're really able only to see 3 of the 7 stars in this star pattern. In the last portion of this video, we will use a Venn diagram to show the difference between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper. This is something I do with all my Versus videos. And if you haven't seen my other Versus videos, go check out that playlist. So let's begin. These two star patterns are similar because they're both asterisms, they're both circumpolar, and they both contain the same number of stars in their pattern. However, the Big Dipper is larger in size. The asterism pattern is different than that of the constellation pattern it's a part of. The Big Dipper is just a smaller portion of the larger constellation known as Ursa Major. And all 7 stars of the Big Dipper are of similar brightness, which makes it easier to find. The curve of the handle is also different than that of the Little Dipper. The Little Dipper is smaller in size. The asterism pattern is the same as the constellation pattern, which is rare in terms of asterism patterns. And only 3 of the stars of the Little Dipper are bright. The other 4 are dim, and that makes it difficult to find in the night sky. Also, the curve of the handle is different. I have these 2 little diagrams I drew to show you that. Here, the handle curves in one direction, and then the curve is different on the Little Dipper, as well as the brightness. That's why the size of the dots are different. So I hope this video was helpful for you in learning the similarities, but ultimately the differences between the two, so you can recognize them when you go outside at night. So to recap one more time, the Big Dipper and Little Dipper are similar because they're both circumpolar asterisms, they're of similar shape, and they're important in terms of celestial navigation. However, they're different in terms of size, the magnitude of the 7 stars they each contain, and the handles do curve differently. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Be sure to check out the link below if you want some special deals to gain access to that awesome learning platform. I know it's been super helpful for me to grow my business and just learn different skills. And let me know in the comments, are you able to find the Big and Little Dippers? Do you have any tricks that I didn't talk about in this video that helps you? And of course, be sure to keep going outside, get practice by spending time in nature. It's the greatest thing we can do for ourselves. Seek out dark skies if you can. And as always, keep looking up. Thank you so much for watching.